Hey guys, Ed here. Today we have a 2016 Hyundai Sonata. In this video, I'll tell you what you need to know about your Hyundai Sonata maintenance and fluids in this car. Okay, so let's pop the hood and here we go. Okay, let's start with what we see. Over here is the windshield washer fluid. You can top it off with water or washer fluid, whatever you like. If the weather is below freezing temperatures, then you should use anything but water. Well, you should use washer fluid, because if water freezes, it might crack, it might break something actually. Okay, here we go. This is the engine coolant reservoir. Okay, you can top it off right here. Here is the level of the fluid. Yeah, this is full, this is low. This car is a little bit low, so we will top it off with something. This is the radiator cap. Okay, so this you don't open ever. Okay, you don't need this. Most likely you're not gonna ever use this, but here you should be sure that it's always up to the level. If you open this thing when the car was working earlier and you open this cap under the pressure of the radiator and the system, you will get boiling antifreeze in your face, so be careful, you don't want to have that. Here, let's go further. Again, you can use regular antifreeze. I believe it's green in this car. First check which antifreeze you have in a car, and that's the color you should use. In extreme situations, you can also use water, but again, if the weather is below freezing temperatures, water is not recommended. Since if you're gonna leave the car outside for a night and it's gonna be freezing temperature, something might crack. So be careful about that. Next thing is power steering fluid, which you don't have in this car, because this car has electric power steering pump. Okay. Same thing with. All right. This is brake, DOT-3 or DOT-4. Brake fluid. This thing should always be on level, because this fluid doesn't evaporate. If you are missing some brake fluid, most likely you have a leak somewhere, and that's pretty bad. So always make sure it's to the limit. You also have a min and max sign, and around here should be the middle. Next thing, transmission. I didn't find, and I checked online, I couldn't find the dipstick for this car, so I assume there is no transmission dipstick in this car. It's made so only the dealer or mechanic could actually check and service the transmission. So you don't have that, nothing to worry about. The last thing is the motor oil. Okay, if you need to add oil, use this cap, unscrew and close if you need to add. How to check the oil? Take a rag. The car should be cold. If you were driving, let it sit for 20 minutes at least. But the best way to check oil is when it's cold in the morning. First thing you do before starting the car, check oil. And that's how you know it's correct level and velocity and everything. So let's check. Take a rag, take a dipstick, pull it out. Okay, try it off. Put it back in. Pull it out. Okay, here we see that oil level is at full. This is the car was working a little bit, that's why the oil raised up. It was working maybe 15 minutes back, so the oil a little bit raised up, but the color of oil I don't like. It's black. Okay, it's dirty, so this should be changed. I'm gonna tell guys to change the oil in this car. And yeah, this is how you actually check it. Very simple. Then you just put the dipstick back in place and you're all set. So this is pretty much all fluid maintenance you should. There is also the AC fluid. Okay, if you want to add it yourself, but this is 2016 car, I'm pretty much sure that all the maintenance is done by mechanics or dealer now. This is the lower hose. If you're adding the end, the Freon through the bottle, so this is the one you're gonna use. You're gonna unscrew it, plug it, and it uses, I believe, 134R. Yes, you see, 134A R Freon. Okay, so guys, this is it. If you find this helpful, press like and have a great day. Bye.